In this video, we're going to look at how we can bring in baked animation simulated within Marvelous Designer and bring that in into Unreal Engine using Morph Targets. Now, this is an overall video where I'll show you some of the steps of the process. I'm not going to go into detail on every step. I'll do a longer video to do that, where I'll use Character Creator, iClone, Marvelous Designer, and of course Unreal Engine. But for this video, the steps that I'm about to show you can be applied to any other software. You can use Blender or you can use Maya and achieve the same thing. All you need to do is learn how to use Morph Targets and how to implement them and bring them into Unreal. Now, if you work with DAZ Studio and your animations come from DAZ Studio into Unreal, I would suggest that you look at tutorials on how to go from Marvelous Designer into DAZ, into Unreal, because there's a script that will make all this process a lot faster. So if you're using DAZ animations, look for a video that helps you doing that. Okay, so first step is to, after you created your garment and you have your character and the animation for your character, the first step is to come here inside of Marvelous Designer, go to import, select FBX, and select your character with the embedded animation. So you have to export from the application that you're using the character with the animation and obviously with no garment on. Then when you open it, make sure you have animation clicked on, leave autoscale on, you press OK, and it brings in the character with the animation and no garment. When you export your character from your software, make sure that the first frame of the animation is main pose, so T-pose or A-pose, whatever you choose. This is so that we don't have to rearrange the placement for the clothes. Clothes is already in the right place, if you know what I mean. Then you go into animation. There's something wrong with my character here. Let me just increase the size of my timeline here. And the first frame I have my regular pose, which in this case is a T-pose. And from the second frame onwards, I have my animation. There's an issue with my character here on the longer video. This won't happen because I'll re-import all of this. Supposedly, the whole character should be in the right place. You go to the first frame, you press simulate so that the clothes goes onto the character for the first frame. And then after the simulation it's done and the clothes is in a resting pose, you press record. When you press record, it's going to record simulation all up to the end of the animation. Again, I'll explain this in better detail on the next video. Once you have your animation recorded and the simulation is okay, you can play it. And keep in mind, if I go into real time, this is 30 frames per second, which is the same thing as Unreal. So that's what we have there, 30 frames per second. On the export, let's talk about this for a second. You have Alembic. You can use Alembic, and if I export Alembic from here and then import it as a skeletal mesh in Unreal, you get the animation with the garment, only the garment. Now, you can use Alembic and try to connect that through a blueprint with your skeletal, your character skeletal mesh, but there's quite a few downsides for that. Using Morph Targets versus Alembic is lighter on performance, lighter on file size, it keeps the mesh skinned, preserves the integrity, and preserves timing. That's why you're using Morph Targets instead of Alembic. So what we do here on the export is we select object sequence, and we export that. Okay, when you're saving it, you can select your avatar and just send the avatar, but in our case, we're just going to select all patterns, so we're going to be selecting only the garment. Choose single object, make sure you weld, otherwise parts of the garment will be unwelded and open. Unified UV coordinates, just click on that and leave it the settings as it is. The scale, choose DAZ Studio, and have play region only selected. Remember, you only record the animation, you don't record the first frame. You can if you want. Then you press OK, and that's gonna, it's gonna give you an object sequence. And this object sequence is, in this case, the garment, and every single frame of the animation is an object, which we're going to use for Morph Targets. So basically, this frame is an object, and then this frame is an object, this is another object, and they all have the same geometry, but with different vertex positions. Then the next step is going back to your application, Blender, Maya, iClone, whatever you're using, and you could create those morph targets using those object files. So what I have here, for example, iClone works at the 60 frames per second. So you can see that here is where my animation starts, and I have a blank keyframe right there, and then one keyframe. So I know that Marvelous works at 30 frames per second, these works at 60 frames per second, so I leave an empty keyframe and I use that. Now, of course, you can use less morph targets than the whole animation. You can, for example, if the animation has 60 morph targets, you can try and get away with just using 30 morph targets and going from frame 0 to frame 2 instead of going from frame 1 0 to frame 1 and use all of the morph targets. Here I have all my morph targets, as you can see here, and they're all split up by sliders. If I go into my morph animator inside of iClone, you can see that as I change frame, each one of these are all sliders, morph target sliders, and they change to go with the animation, and we get that result. So the garment is connected to the character as an accessory. If I just show you here the scene, here we go. You can see that this is my character, and the garment, the vest here, is inside of my skeletal structure as an accessory. It's connected to the root bone. Once you get that in place, you have to export it as an FBX with the animation. Then inside of Unreal, when you import your FBX, you have to make sure that import morph targets is on. And if I go into my morph target list here, these are all the morph targets that come from character creator. And here we have our morph targets, all the sequence morph targets from Marvelous Designer. And you can see what's happening as the animation runs. The morph targets are one at a time getting applied to the animation. If I go to animation, I can check out my curves, and you can see these are all the morph targets that are responsible for that animation. So I chose in this case to bring every single frame, but of course you don't need to do that. Now, one thing to keep in mind here, I'm going from the last frame up to the first frame so that it works in as a continuous loop. If you know how to use morph targets, I think you can achieve that with your software. So that is an overall look at the process, and in the next video I'm going to show you how to achieve this with the softwares that I used to do so. So I'll see you in the next video.